Hi everyone, today I'm going to explain what the range of a function is and why it should be important to us in math. The range of a given function is a set of all possible outputs that can be achieved through entering all the possible inputs, which remember is the domain of the function. So, put simpler, the range of a function is every possible y or output value that we can get through entering every possible x value into our function. So, looking at the ordered pair idea that we introduced previously, the domain is a set of all the possible first components in our ordered pair listings, and the range is a set of all possible second components. This is why the order of x and y is very important in ordered pairs. We always list the independent, or the input, first, and then the output, or the dependent variable, second. So in the ordered pair, we have x and then y. Therefore, our set of values in the range is strictly dependent on the domain of the function. That is, the domain of the function directly alters what values can be achieved within the range. To find the range, it is typically easiest to graph the function. So let's do a couple examples to make sure we understand. Let's say we have f of x equals 12 minus x squared. What is the domain and range of this function? Since there are no radicals present and no divide by 0, let's begin by plotting y at x equals 0. So y equals 12 at x equals 0. As x increases or decreases, the graph will open parabolically downward as both result in 12 minus an increasingly positive number. Therefore, our domain is all real numbers and the range is represented by capital R colon round bracket negative infinity 2 12 square bracket. Let's just show you a couple more graphs to really understand domain and range. What is the domain and range in graph 1? Well, since we have a filled in hole at minus 1, we must include that in our domain. And since it dips to the origin and up to positive 5 in our y, our range is 0 to 5. The domain is including minus 1, 2, but not including 5, since there is a hole at 5. So we show that with a round bracket. What if we have a function 1 over x plus 1? The domain has a hole at minus 1. So the domain is all real numbers except for minus 1. For this function, the graph looks like this. For this function, both domain and range are not defined at negative 1, so we write that like so. Let's do one more final domain and range question to make sure you really understand. What if we have the square root of 3x? If we enter a negative for x, then we have a negative under our square root, so we know that x must be greater than or equal to 0 to be defined. Therefore, the graph looks like this. So, the domain of this function is all values of x greater than or equal to 0. The range will be all values greater than 0, as the y value will continually grow as we move further down the x-axis. So, we denote the domain and range in interval notation like so. Be sure to use a square bracket if you want to include the value like we did here with 0. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support our channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.